Okay, looking through my comments here, and I saw this one a few days ago, and as you know, I was like, down and out, so I was putting it in the back of my mind. Grant Prey leaves some absolutely amazing comments. He's very encouraging. He's positive. He gives me feedback in a sense that, you know, it's like not just always, you know, you're awesome. If he wants to see something different, he lets me know, and I appreciate that because that's how I get better. I had always mentioned how I think farming the Sith ships is great because they might be a meta. I cannot believe I didn't think of this, and he did. And he says that you mentioned the Sith being a meta at some point. That is possible. But I also feel that the Ebon Hawk will have a similar event to the Millennium Falcon, but it will require Sith ships. Mind-blowing. How in the world did I not think of that? Of course he's right. We have to get these scoundrel ships for the Falcon here. And, I mean, the B-28 Extinction Class Bomber. Really, you know, it's like, oh, they, you know, a cool ship. Where'd that come from? Why did they drop it at this time? Two scenarios, in my opinion. And both of them are probably likely. One, they're going to drop a Sith capital ship pretty soon. The Ravager or Saul Kareth or Darth Malak if he has his own. But most likely, which Grant is correct, he's going to be needed for the Ebon Hawk. So please, for the love of all that is good and holy in this world, be farming your Sith ships. You know, I made a mistake. I made a game-playing mistake. When the Scoundrel ships came out, I did not farm them right away. I let them sit. And I've started to farm them the last few days. I got one of the packs. And I'm probably going to be able to get the Falcon at 5 stars. Do I want it higher? Of course I do. But hey, like I said, moving in on my own. Can't really afford all that. We'll have to see where the chips lay. See what I can do. But I at least want it at 5 stars. But the Sith Fighter is something I'm farming every day. So I'm going to have that to 7 stars. And then, like I said, I'm working on the Extinction Class Bomber, which just came out. So please, work on the Sith ships. I don't know if they're going to release more Sith ships because, you know, these are more of the era, but maybe the TIE Advanced will be needed, even though it has nothing really to do with the Ebon Hawk. Maybe the Scimitar will be needed, but you should have those ships being farmed anyway. But any other Sith ships that come out, please be farming and be ready for that because I think the Ebon Hawk's going to be the best ship in the game. Probably that and the Falcon. And actually, I love the Ebon Hawk more than the Millennium Falcon. But then again, I'm a complete nerd when it comes to that stuff. We're just going to go in and we're going to do a fleet battle here right now because I am working towards getting towards first. And this is the same team I run, except I have my house tooth at 7 stars. So let's see how we can do. I keep forgetting. That is doing nothing for me right now, the Slave 1. It calls in and it gets retribution, but Biggs is able to take more damage. Maybe that's, I don't know. We'll have to see. I keep changing things up because I don't know what to do. I like to try different reinforcement abilities. I do not have a meta team. I have a team that's able to get first, but is it meta defining? Absolutely not. Of course, their TIE Silencer is going to go first. Now, most people say, come in, try to stun the Houndstooth. I'm going to try that. Is it going to get stunned here? Probably not. Hey, I got lucky. Awesome. Because now I get to come in, give Breach on their TIE Advanced. Maybe you guys think this is a bad idea, but I'm going to try to knock it out as quickly as possible. Their Thrawn goes first. I'm actually going to give myself some offense up. And we're going to start going to town here. Okay, get rid of you. Oh my, see, look at that. Look at the dodges. Of course it's because I'm playing. So I lost an attack on TIE Silencer. Imagine that. Okay, bring in Phantom. Speaking of which, I have the Phoenix characters at gear 11, except for Ezra, I have at gear 12 with the Zeta. I'm going to get them to gear 12 because I think when we use the Falcon, they're going to be very useful. Decent amount of damage there. Okay, good. They brought in Biggs. Not a big-time damage dealer. That's going to help me out big-time survive. Oh, nice. Come on. Finish! Yes! That helps tremendously. Okay, now I have to attack Biggs. Not much of a threat right now. Let's bring in the Ghost, because I like the synergy with Ghost and Phantom. And use its AoE, because it can do some big hits. I cannot wait to give you guys some footage of the Millennium Falcon when I unlock it. I'm totally pumped about that, you know. Let's see here, I don't want to do this. And it's going to be just, you know, real footage. I don't have a test account, which is okay. because I like doing this, showing you guys the old-fashioned way. You know, grinding, we on the grind. Okay. Oh, crap. We got a reinforcement called in. Of course, it's the slave one. Oh, let's get Taunt up again. I wonder, again, I watched some of the other YouTubers' videos, obviously. I always do that because I like to learn things that I don't exactly know myself. And is the Houndstooth going to be as viable? Of course we dodge. Why wouldn't we dodge? That just doesn't make any, or, you know, why wouldn't we not dodge? It doesn't make any sense. Is the Houndstooth still going to be viable? Of course it is in some aspects, I believe. But we're going to have to see. Why did I not bring in a tank there? It's still going to be good, so don't worry about that. We just have to figure out exactly how. Finally, I got a dodge. Game, set, match. Perfect. There, I got to 8th. So, talking about the Sith ships, talking about the Scoundrel ships. What else do you guys think is going to be coming here in the game? Okay, I'm going to do this battle right here so we can talk a little more. Ship-wise... I want to know your guys' opinion. What new capital ships? Okay, General Grievous, he's going to get a rework during the Clone Wars. Now, he's going to get a capital ship. Okay, pretty darn sure he's going to get a capital ship. I would be extremely surprised if he didn't. But here's my question. Do you think he will be... I think I want to do this. Probably shouldn't have attacked him there. That was dumb because I was talking. The Malevolence. A ship he had in three episodes of the Clone Wars TV series. Great ship, very powerful. It would make sense because it has a special ability. But are you going to go with a ship that he used for three episodes of the Clone Wars? Are you going to go with a ship that he actually used during the Battle of Coruscant in Revenge of the Sith? And that ship is the Invisible Hand. I tend to think it will be the Invisible Hand. That doesn't mean I'm correct. I can completely see why they're going to go with the Malevolence, because they'll have a... The special ability they can have with the Malevolence will totally fit into the game. You know, you can completely take out one whole ship like Thrawn, or it can completely disable the enemy ships for like two turns of the battle, which would actually kind of be cool because that's kind of what it does in the... It's an ion weapon in the Clone Wars TV series. So that, and I seriously think that we're going to have... Come on. Well, okay, take them out. I that might have been unnecessary, but hey. I seriously think we're going to have a Sith capital ship, as mentioned earlier. Which one do you guys think it is? I know Saul Kareth is unlikely, but he was a minor cool character in the game. Nihilus does have the Ravager. And again, ships is something I really want to see grow in the game because I personally love it. Again, I've told you before, this is a very ships has a love-hate relationship. There's no in-between. It's not, I can't wait for ships to do it. I love it. It's either that or people are... Why am I even doing this? I'm not even going to try to climb. Yes, this is huge. Huge because I get to do this. Okay, they're going to call in a reinforcement, of course. This is still where things get dicey. Let's take you out because they're still going to use... I think actually we can come in. I'm going to call all the assists, and we'll be able to take them out of there. Nice! Okay, he's taken out. So see, I'm still able to climb. Sometimes I get luckier than not. Sometimes the AI likes to help me out, sometimes it doesn't. But again, just a few fleet battles there, you know, with a team that I'm going to see how it can compete against a Falcon team. I'm guessing it's just going to get destroyed. But we'll see. So, leave me comments in the comment section below. What ships do you think are going to come? Do you think the Sith ships are going to be needed for the Ebon Hawk like Grant does and I do? Grant Prey, that is. Again, thank you for all the wonderful comments. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please smash the subscribe button, like the video, click the notification bell so you can be alerted to all videos that I post. Also, I'm leaving a link to my Discord server and Patreon page in the description below. Please make sure you check that out. And again, I say this 1,000 times. I'm probably getting annoying with it. Leave comments in the comment section, please. What videos do you want to see? Because your video ideas, I get the video ideas from here, guys. What videos do you want to see? I feel like I kind of stagnated a little bit. I need to keep going and growing. Again, roster reviews are going to happen, just not as frequently. So I'll get there. I want to focus on you know, really growing this better as well and getting more Territory Wars content, Grand Arena content out there. Otherwise, peace out and may the Force be with you.